Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Mario Odyssey. Last time, we finished up the- Okay, Mario. We finished up the Mushroom Kingdom by refighting every boss- Well, not every boss, but six of the bosses from the game. Could you go in the door? You know, from all around the kingdom. There were six different rooms, six different bosses. We did that, then we went and found a fire piranha plant, because I had apparently never captured a fire piranha plant, so... Anywho, in this episode, we are heading on to the final kingdom of the game, Darkerside. And I figured we're gonna go ahead and do it in the gold Mario suit, because, while I haven't grinded up to 9999 coins, I think the adventure itself has made us all rich. And thus, golden, right? I also just kinda wanted to play in the gold Mario suit, I'm not gonna lie, it's been a while. Here we go, on to Darkerside. Yeah, they're doing that. They're playing the freaking... the thing. And you know who's playing the thing? Why, it's Pauline, of course, over here. Hi.
Hello.
Go, Mario, jump, man. I get it. She's actually singing it. I love this. I love it. Anyway, everybody is here. We got Dory right there. We got one of each of the types of villagers. We got... villagers? You know what I mean. The inhabitants of the different places. We got Toad. I don't quite know where Captain Toad and the Toad Brigade are, but... it's whatever. Why are you not joining in? I'm proud of you for trying this. Oh! I thought I died. I'm not gonna lie. I thought I just died right there. Proud of you for trying this. Trying what, you may be asking? Frog, could you not? Well, you see, not quite that. Well, we got a little bit of a platforming challenge. This doesn't seem too bad, right? Yeah, just frogging our way up here. Like so. Oh dear. Oh god, don't fail it. I was gonna say, don't fail this early. Good god, I was making a funny. Alright, let's get up here. Okay, even more frogging? Okay, that's fine. Even more frogging. Here we go, warp pipe time. Okay, or not. Odyssey, yes, see, let's go. Mario in the pipe. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this game's The Perfect Run. Welcome to this game's... well, not The Perfect Run, because you've got three hearts. Never mind. This game's Grandmaster Galaxy, this game's Champions Road, or whatever the heck it's called in 3D World. This game's final level that's really difficult, because, of course, that's what this is. You know, okay, well, didn't want to make that apparently, Mario, did you? This is that one challenge level that Nintendo likes to throw at the end of every Mario game nowadays to make it, to just make a hard level, basically. I'm not complaining, though, because I'll be honest, this is probably the most fun one out of all of them. And I recommend you beat that guy because he gives you a life up heart. And for some reason, there's still some Goombas over there, but whatever, let's move. As Cappy mentioned, we are no longer in moon physics, this is regular physics. And, it is a challenge level. You die anywhere in this level, you get sent right back to the beginning. So don't die, basically, is the advice that I can give you. But, like I said, it's probably the most fun one out of any of these types of challenge levels that are in any of the Mario games. Okay, let's not die already, Mario, that'd be great. But I would also argue that it's probably the easiest. I'm not gonna lie. It's not the It's not the most difficult thing in the world, but I don't want to say that and then die, even though that's probably what's gonna happen. Why have I got input delay? Why do I have input delay? What is happening? This is messing with me. Okay, hold on, hold on. My controller had input delay for a second. I was freaking out. It's gone now, but it was there. All right, lava bubble, come here, friend. There we go, of course. This level is, of course, going to throw everything at you. Everything you've learned throughout the game is gonna throw at you right here, and yeah, I'm okay with that. I like levels that do this. Oh dear. Alright, you know what? It's fine. Take the hit. I don't mind. What is up there? You're just hiding coins? I don't care about those. I don't need no coins. I got Balloon World. I don't even need to grind up to max coins anymore. There we go. Fire on over there. Do I want to get out of Lava Bubble, or is there something around here if we go around with Lava Bubble? That is indeed a something, and I will take it. I will take it, but I think we can leave Lava Bubble now. I don't think we need him up here. But we do have a Stretchy Boy! Hi, friend! Although with Stretchy Boy, you can kind of cheese some of these areas, like you can skip some corners like that. It's not too difficult. It's a Stretchy Boy section. I enjoy me a Stretchy Boy section every now and again. Because I enjoy me some Stretchy Boy. You know, he's fun. Except when you die, let's not die. Please don't hit me. I can't hit you when I'm Stretchy Boy. Oh, see what I mean about cheesing sections? You can kind of do it right there. Like so. Alright, not bad. Are you hiding something up here? You look like you're hiding a block. With a heart inside of it. Alright, so they do kind of replenish your health as you go through, should you take damage, but again, highly recommend you take down that boss at the beginning to get the life up heart, because, you know, just in case. Just to have that extra health, it makes sense. There goes Stretchy Boy, and now we're in a cold area. Okay, cool. With fuzzies as well. You know, that's fine. It's not too big of a deal. You know what, just tank it. Don't care, just take the hit from the fuzzies. Alright, we're gonna ground pound jump, wall jump. Get out of there, okay. Ooh, Yoshi. Okay, totally down for Yoshi time. Get him, there we go. And I think, can Yoshi eat the fuzzies? Yoshi cannot eat the fuzzies. Yoshi can tongue the floor and run into the fuzzies because he's a fool. You know what, that's fine. I do really, really like this section though, because it's like, you got these conveyors constantly going up so you can actually rise up with Yoshi. But you've got to switch sides, use his tongue to do so, and avoid the fuzzies. It's just fun. It's real fun. I see Sphinxy Boy in the background there. I did not think we were going to be seeing him again, but I'm not complaining. Don't you do it. Don't you dare. Oh, I guess we have to hit those. Why would I want to hit those? Obviously to destroy the blocks, but like, what's the point? There's nothing to collect in here. There's just one Power Moon at the end. So, what would be the need in destroying these blocks? Update, I've got input delay again. I'm not crazy. It is happening. Okay. Am I too far away from my Switch? What's happening here? Either way, we made it. Hi, Sphinxy Boy. Sorry, you don't speak to Yoshis, do you?
Greetings, traveler, and to your hat as well. Can you answer my riddle? What is the only kingdom that I, the Great Sphinx, have not visited?
The Mushroom Kingdom, I believe. Yeah, he wasn't there.
Dear ye giver of the correct answers, take this with you.
Oh, and he gives us another life up heart, should we need it, which we don't, but hey, I'll take it. Hopefully I don't have input delay anymore. Or it doesn't come back at any point. That would be great. Because having input delay in the final level of the game, the challenge level, is not going to be a good time. Alright, so this right here. You're supposed to go down there, hit that guy, and then it makes a bunch of platforms appear. You've got to make your way up without Cappy. Or, if I can remember how to do this, which I honestly can't. Yes, I can. We're just gonna ground pound and then hit the cap throw button, then shake. Okay, not quite. No, Mario! Ground pound, cap throw. Didn't quite work. Ground pound, cap throw, shake it. No, there is a way to do this. Not like that though. Not like that. We need to be up here when Cappy hits that, essentially. I'm doing it too early. Oh god, I'm terrified. Freaking terrified. Okay. Okay, Cappy, you had it. Cappy, you had it. He got it! Alright, so you have to hold in the direction towards it, but then Cappy gets on that, you're on this platform and it takes you up, you don't have to do the little platforms. Why would you not do it this way? And it also gives you a heart up top, because they totally actually intended for you to do it that way. Or, like, they gave you that as an option. The only issue is we now have to wait for Cappy, but... That's fine, you can see what you would have had to do. You know what, I'm gonna move just in case those pop out. Which I don't think they do, but just in case. Oh, they totally do. Okay, good job, I moved. Cappy, come back to me, friend. Because we've got a Glide-On, friend. Now, if you didn't know about shaking the controller to make Glide-On go up like this, then you'd be kind of, well, not screwed in this area, because obviously you're intended to do it that way. But it's a lot more difficult if you don't know that. If you do know that, you can just shake the controller over and over again and make it over here, arguably without even having to hit the little tornado things. In fact, we might just make it without hitting the tornadoes. I think I hit one earlier, but you really don't need to. You know what else you don't need to do? This platforming section down here. You can just skip past it with Glide-On. And that is exactly how I recommend you do it. Because screw those little forks. Alright, I'm sorry if you wanted to see me do that the intended way, but... Maybe that... Oh, no. I forgot about this section. Completely forgot about this section. Okay, so... Obviously you got these dudes. You hit that, it kills the dudes. But it doesn't kill all the dudes. It doesn't break the blocks either. Not that you would really want to break the blocks. But it also kind of sets you on an infinite loop with these things. I might have made a mistake doing this. Please don't kill me. Please don't kill me. Oh, for the love of... I've made a mistake. Mistakes have been made. Does that send us back to the beginning? It's gonna send us back to the beginning, isn't it? Mistakes were made today, folks. Oh my god, you've got to be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me. Again, I was shaking the controller to do the glide and hit the ZL button. And that jumped me right on out of Glide-On. You know, I missed out a key detail here about Darkerside. You don't even have to go in that pipe. You can fly straight past the pipe. Over here. Please don't die, Mario. Please. Oh, no, he can't. You have got to be kidding me! You can do that. I just wasn't high enough up. Also, I didn't jump out of Glide-On. He jumped out of Glide-On himself. Like I said, you can make it over there to that painting with Glide-On right here and just skip this next section. But you know what? We're doing this the legitimate way. Guess how many deaths I've cut out? I don't know. I lost count. I didn't want to include every single one of them, though, so I didn't. What I will say, though, is my recording is currently at 30 minutes. Almost 31 minutes. So, I've been going for a while. I've been doing this for a little while. So, what I recommend in this area is not doing what I did before. Actually, don't hit the thing in the middle. But kind of like that. Oh, God. Is that permanently active now? It might as well be, because it's going to keep getting hit by the other ones. Damn it. I was going to say don't hit it and just kill the enemies using Cappy, but it's a little bit late for that now, so we're just going to have to deal with it, and hopefully we can just make it through here. I mean, we're probably going to take some hits, but it's not a huge deal, because we do have the life up hut. All right, let's go. That I know we can clear. Oh, and it's Pokio. Little Poke boy, how's it going, buddy? Let's go on an adventure. Okay, I'm a little scared. I'm a little scared. He's a little bendy right now. I forgot about this section, honestly. It does scare me a little bit. A lot, a bit. Alright, here we are back at the Pokio section. Let me see if we can get a better look at this. Sorry, Pokio. Okay, so there's a heart. It looks like it's a relatively short section, actually, so I'm hopeful we can do it on this try, because if we don't, there's a whole lot of level to do again. I don't like when you grab it like that, Pokio. I don't like when you grab the edge. Alright, I'm gonna take it slow. You know, just analyze what we've got to do here. Okay, so I think my mistake last time is I pushed forward, and I don't think I should have done that. I'm actually gonna try something else. Oh my god, you can just shake and do the high fling to get up there. Okay, 4 HP. Missed out on the heart, but you know what? That's fine. 4 HP should be enough. that allows us three hits. We've got an 8-bit section. See, this is why I didn't really want to fly over to the Bowser painting, because there's a lot of sections that get skipped, like this one, for example. This is really neat. Okay, well, until that happens, you just gotta go around here and hit the blocks, just like we did in the New Donk City Festival. Hit that Kong down, there we go. That opens this up, and we can leave. Or, there we go. I've been going for like 38 minutes now, by the way. I did not expect this to take that long, and that's all that you skip. This brings you to this Bowser painting, which is of course Bowser with Mario's mustache and hat, which means... Yep, we got another one of these sections. I don't actually know if it's any different or if it's just the same, but I guess we'll see. Actually, no, it is. It's totally different. I honestly forgot this was a thing, but it's neat. And apparently it gave us our health back, which I am perfectly fine with. Okay, well, not if we start losing it over and over again. I'd rather that didn't happen. All right, here we go. This section's a pain because Bowser takes... Oh, God, there we go. It's honestly best to just tank the hits here, because you're not going to get hit by all of those. There you go. We only got hit by one in there. It's just a bit of a pain to turn around and hit the little rolling blocks and everything. And, oh, I guess boulders is the correct term. And then turn back around. It just takes so long. You might as well just tank a hit or two, depending on what it requires. Oh, is that... That's it for that section? Wait a minute. Did we do it? I think we might have done it. Everything's golden. We did it! I knew picking Gold Mario was the right idea. We've done it. Oh my god. You can also, you can skip over these letters by shaking the controller, I think. Like, you know, go to the next one. Like, take a little jump. But you know what? At this point, I'm not risking that. I'm not about to risk taking a jump like that. There's a little UFO guy. We did it. Thank you. What do you want? Oh, that's neat. Yeah, thank you. Give me my hat back. Thank you. That's all I wanted. Just wanted my hat back. Oh my god, here we are. What do you got for us? What are you gonna show us? Just this big tall building? Long journey's end, folks. Long journey's end. Looks like we got a multi-moon up there. You know what, it'd be great if we could get out of it. There we go. Frogman, I'm gonna need you real quick. Just saying. Here we go, and of course this is the building we could see from all the way over there. There's the Odyssey. We've come a long way, you and me. We've seen a bunch of different kingdoms. Think of all the hats! This trip really was amazing. Thank you, Mario. It's been an honor walking a mile on your head. I love this game. Told you there was another hat left. We're now completely invisible. Yup, we got the invisibility hat. Kind of interesting that you don't get to see what it looks like, obviously because it's invisible. But judging by the shadow, it's just a regular Mario hat. Oh, everybody's confused. They don't know where we are. Pauline? Pauline, do you at least know I'm here? Do you know I'm here? Go. Oh, she does. She knows I'm here. Oh, that's good. That is good. But hey, folks. Guess what? We may have done Long Journey's End. We may have had that little emotional moment with Cappy. But we're not quite done. Well, let's deposit our 3 moons. For one thing. It brings us up to 880. Yeah, there it is. There it is. The Odyssey sail has turned golden. We have all the power moons. Now, you can obviously go buy more power moons from the stores to get it up to 999, but we're not going to be doing that in this Let's Play. I've done it on my own file, but there's no point doing it for the Let's Play. We have one episode left, folks. Just one more episode. As you saw right there, a new portrait of Bowser has opened up in the wedding hall. And that is what we're going to be taking on in the next episode, in the finale. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.